Weight loss is a side effect of wellness. I love this. This is what today's Turquoise Talk guest firmly, firmly believes in. And we had a great conversation talking about autoimmune disease, talking about hormones, talking about the significance of functional nutrition and the ability to heal or reverse autoimmune conditions. So it's jam-packed full of information, and I'm so thankful that we're having these conversations to overcome some of the misconceptions about menopause or hormones or autoimmune disease. And so she also shares two attributes that she has seen. She's worked with very, very successful athletes, artists, just very, very successful people. And she shares two attributes every successful person has. Welcome to the Mompreneur Life Remix podcast, where you will learn how to remix your mompreneur life so that you can win at work without losing yourself in the process. Hi, my name is Martine Williams, and I am your host and CEO, your chief encouragement officer. And this podcast is your one-stop shop to creating a burnout-proof life and business and elevating your clarity, confidence, and courage. Friends, it's time to say goodbye to being the yes girl and hello to creating healthy boundaries, healthy mindsets, and healthy habits. Your next breakthrough starts here. This is the Mompreneur Life Remix podcast. Let's do this. So let me tell you a little bit about our guest today. Her name is Risa Gru, and she is a functional nutritionist and certified autoimmune coach. She's in private practice in Newport Beach, California. And she has always been passionate about nutrition and good health. She firmly believes that the body can heal itself with whole foods that we obtain from the earth and sees living proof of that in her office each day. She actually shares some really powerful testimonies on this episode. She looks at root causes using functional nutrition guidelines, blood and stool tests, and knows that weight loss is a side effect of wellness. Love that. All right. Without further ado, let's dive into today's episode. Welcome back, friends. I'm so excited for today's Turquoise Talk guest, Risa Gru. I'm so excited to have you on the show to talk about a very complex topic, and there's lots of information out there. And so I'm excited to have you on the show and just ask the questions that I know so many of my listeners are probably having. So before we dive into that, I would love to just know a little bit more about you and your journey and how you kind of got into this business that you're in now as a autoimmune coach.
Yeah. So basically I grew up with a really bad relationship with food.
Okay.
Mom was perpetually on a diet, trying to lose 5 or 10 pounds perpetually. My grandma was doing the same thing in her house. All the women around me just had this bad relationship with food. They were saying these foods are good and these foods are bad. And I was very confused because I always thought the bad foods tasted pretty good to me. So I was just really like very just, you know, just confused. And then, of course, when I got into high school, what did I do? I started going on every diet and every diet book that came out, and I was trying to lose my 3 pounds. And so I would go from this gorging, well, maybe not gorging, but just eating whatever I wanted to eating, you know, nothing or eating very little. And it was a whole thing of deprivation and starvation. And I really just had a bad relationship with food. So I was always interested in nutrition. I really wanted to do a deep dive in that. I ended up going in a completely different course in my career. And I was in sports marketing and worked for a lot of professional teams. But when I got married, we got pregnant immediately. It was just like not an issue. Got pregnant, conceived, easy peasy. Had a great pregnancy. And then when we tried for our second, it was a different story. So it took us a long time. And every time I would get pregnant, I would lose the baby. And there were just all these things going on. So I finally acquiesced and went to a fertility specialist who basically told me that I had an underachieving thyroid. And here passed me this prescription for thyroid medication. I was like, how long do I take this for?
Right.
He said, you know, every day. And I'm like, well, like for how long? And he said, for the rest of your life. When I walked out of that meeting, I said, I had two burning questions. One, why is my thyroid an underachiever? Why is it not producing the hormone that it was born to produce? And the second one was, why is the doctor not concerned about this and giving me a synthetic medication to mimic exactly what my thyroid should be producing? And so I ended up realizing that I had this gene mutation that's very, very common. I test everybody for it, called MTHFR. I took the proper B vitamin. I ended up getting pregnant, no problems. But after that, a few years after my son was born, I went to a naturopathic doctor. I went back to school for nutrition at that time. And they had told me that I had now had Hashimoto's. So now my body was attacking my thyroid gland. And I'm like, okay, this is not, you know, this train is off the track. We got to get this right back on the track. So I did my deep dive and realized that there were all these root causes that cause autoimmunity. And so I went down each and every single one. I couldn't find a list, so I put one together for myself. Of course, I had every single one. I treated all those. I put it in my book, Food Frame, and I became a clinical nutritionist and found functional medicine. And after that, I became a functional nutritionist, which means that I am looking at root causes. I'm focusing on prevention. I look at labs very extensively, and I consider the whole body one interconnected unit. Mm-hmm. All has to do with each other. And then I became a certified autoimmune coach, and I work with so many autoimmune patients, but I'm really a functional nutritionist that kind of specializes in autoimmunity.
Right, right. What I love about your story, like even as I was reading it, getting to know you before we came on, is just, I am a firm believer that our past struggles become our present purposes. And for you to have gone through the journey, learned through the journey, figured it out, and now you're not just moving on with your life, you're actually reaching back and helping other people with that. And I just think that's so important. And that's really why we go through those hard times, because there's someone who's listening right now who's, you know, thinking like, what's wrong with me? Or maybe they did go to see the physician and they just gave them a pill and like, well, there you go. That's how you have to live the rest of your life. And so I just love that you're going, you know, teaching this and written books and helping people with this.
And I was able to reverse my Hashimoto's. I have a diagnosis of Hashimoto's. I've been able to have a lot of people reverse their autoimmune diseases. Now, it's not to say that every one of them can be reversed.
Right.
I'm looking at, why do we have it in the first place? Is there a bacterial overgrowth? Is there a virus? Is there a leaky gut? There's multiple things that it could be. And I'm going to go down that list to find it. And if we can reverse it, then let's do it.
Yeah. Yeah. So what do you think are the biggest misconceptions that you see that people have about autoimmune?
That there's a pill for that. Mm. You know, most times, basically when you have autoimmune disease, it's what I say, you have a fire in the basement, right? You have massive inflammation, you have systemic inflammation. These antibodies that are at high levels, whereas without autoimmune disease does not have these antibody productions, they're attacking, right? So we've had antibodies for quite some time probably, and we're going to eventually find a place to park, right? They're going to find a gland, a tissue, an organ, a cell to park themselves in. Mm-hmm. And if we don't put out that fire and don't find the root cause, we're just going to continue to accumulate autoimmune diseases. So I don't think physicians tell their patients that, at least not the ones that come into my office. And usually they're given some kind of a medication that typically doesn't work. Then they get on another medication and then we start taking body parts out. But in the meantime, they feel like crap, whether they're on medication or not, and they're starting to accumulate more autoimmunities. So I feel like people should know that you can stop, you know, hold the phone and let's address and see if we can reverse this. Some things like MS or Parkinson's, we cannot reverse that. But can we slow down the progression? Absolutely, we can. So why wouldn't you want to do that? And you know, when you have this fire in the basement, you basically, this antibody production is when your Th17 from your Treg cells, that's our immune system, Th17 gets activated. And what that does is it causes a cytokine storm, which is an inflammatory cytokine storm, right? And somebody needs to put that inflammation out. I give everybody a Fab Five cocktail of supplements that are all natural anti-inflammatories along with how you eat. I think a major misconception is it doesn't matter what you eat. That is hugely false, hugely false. And unfortunately, our medical, our conventional medicine paradigm does not even look at nutrition. It doesn't. Yeah. They don't go to classes on nutrition. They just don't know. I have several doctors as patients, and I have through the years, many of them, and they don't know. So yes, food absolutely matters, what you put into your body and the chemicals and all that stuff. And usually a doctor does not give them that information.
Yeah.
Statistic is that most people, the average person, goes to 6 physicians or practitioners before they're actually diagnosed with an autoimmune disease. So most people don't even know because they just feel like crap. And then they're given all this medication and they still feel like crap. So Really, yeah. I always feel like, you know, I always say to people, if you feel like something's off, something's off.
Yeah.
Find it. I'm always going to chase it with them. I'll chase them because I'm very curious to find out what it is that has sparked this dysregulation of whatever kind in your body.
Yeah. Yeah. And what are some of those steps? Like someone comes to see you, like what are the things that the process they may go through to kind of get to and identify what the root causes are? Because I do think for a lot of people, it feels very complicated. It feels very hard. It feels like it's going to be a long process. And maybe all of those things are true. But I think sometimes it's just the overwhelm of what is it? Like if the pill seems quick, right? That's the reason why, like, here's a quick fix. And we all want the quick fix. We don't want to go through the process, but it's like, you want a sustainable result, not just a quick fix. So what are some root causes and how do you identify those?
Yeah. So there are many root causes. So one is, it could be a vitamin D deficiency. The other one would be that MTHFR gene mutation I was talking about, which means that you're methylizing or processing either your B12 and or your folate, your B9, which is really important, especially through pregnancy. It could be a shift in hormones, right? So it could be pregnancy. A lot of people are diagnosed like I was after pregnancy, Hashimoto's. It could be menopause. So it could be all of those hormonal shifts. It could be a parasite or a bacteria in your gut. That's why I do a full stool test to find out what's actually going on in the gut. Do we have an overgrowth, right? So I'm working with somebody right now, a Sjogren's. She has a tremendous overgrowth of a bacteria called Roseburia. And so we are in the process of killing that naturally, of course. And her symptoms are completely going away. I mean, all of she came in to see me are gone. So it's, we're going to retest her when she finishes the protocol, which I can't wait for. But it could be that. It could be a virus that sets it off, right? Like Epstein-Barr virus, which most people have, I would say 90% of the population by the time they're 40 is tested positive for it. That's the current statistic. And Epstein-Barr virus comes from the mono virus. So if you ever had mono or you swap spit with anybody who had mono, which pretty much everybody has, you have it in your system, right?
Yeah.
It's dormant like all viruses until it gets activated. So like hormonal shift can activate it, stress, bad diet, lots of alcohol, too much sugar, not enough sleep. Those things can activate a dormant virus. And Epstein-Barr virus can give you blood sugar dysregulation, thyroid dysregulation, and up to 33 autoimmune diseases. So it's those things that can absolutely trigger it. And another root cause is heavy metals. You know, we are all very exposed to lead and to mercury. And I eat a lot of seafood. That's pretty primarily what I live on. And mercury is a buildup. I was very, very high in mercury. Less people have mercury fillings. So things like that, that can cause something to go awry and cause your state of immunity. Leaky gut is a huge, huge, huge factor. And so many people are leaky because we only have one layer of epithelial cells in our intestinal lining. So it's really fragile. And that we're just exposed to so many toxins. Our FDA has approved 86,000 chemicals for us to use. 86,000, way more than any other country on this entire planet. Which there's a big movement going on right now, which I'm very excited about because we're finally getting loud and saying to the government, this is ridiculous. I mean, our diseases are going up. I just got a call the other day from somebody who's 31 years old with an aggressive breast cancer. I mean, this should not be happening.
Yeah. Yeah.
We have way too many toxins and chemicals and we go out for every meal and we're drinking in plastic cups all day. And, you know, we heat up our coffee with our plastic lid and you see the condensation on there. Well, what do you think is dripping in your coffee?
Yeah.
BPA and BBSs, you know, those are not going to help any cancer situation, right? Or fertility or, you know, we're just exposed to so much more, right? And we're not even talking about candles or plug-ins or deodorants or shampoos or nail polishes and God knows what we inject into our body, right?
Right,
so
yeah.
We're just attacked with chemicals. And so we have to be really diligent about decreasing our toxic load.
Yeah, yeah. So when someone comes into your office or decides to work with you, do we do blood work? Do we do like tell them some of the, give them an idea of what the testing would look like so they kind of have an idea of that?
Yeah. So everybody who walks in my door, we are going to go through your whole health history, goals, supplements, medications that you're taking. And then you're going to leave my office or my Zoom call with a order to get a full comprehensive blood screen. So I'm going to look at all four markers of your blood sugar, not just your glucose or your hemoglobin A1C to determine if you're diabetic or pre-diabetic or hypoglycemic. But I'm also going to look at insulin markers to see if you're insulin resistant, because that's a precursor to pre-diabetes. Then we're going to look at all nine markers of your thyroid. We're going to look at all your whole panel for your iron, your inflammatory markers, which no conventional doctors test for, which is insane to me because insurance companies don't cover it, because it is the root cause of disease, right?
Inflammation.
So we don't even test for it. So, you know, we're playing darts with the lights off and we can't see the target. I test for white blood cells, all that stuff. I'm getting a really good idea. All your lipids, all those things, your liver, are we congested? I have a really clear picture of what's going on. If we need to do hormone testing, we can do that as well. And then I test everybody for an MTHFR gene mutation. In addition, you're going to get a stool test. So we're going to see what's going on inside. You know, are you having fat malabsorption? Are you making your own digestive enzymes? Do you have any parasites, worms, candida? What do your good guys look like? What are the bad guys? Do we have any Giardia or H. pylori? I'm looking to see, you know, when you go to a GI doctor, typically you're going to get a test with four markers on it. Yeah. I'm looking at 84. I want to see what's going on in the gut, because that tells us almost everything we need to know. So I'm always looking at the foundational issues, because these are the two major things that either optimize our health or hinder our health. And one is systemic inflammation, which we can get from various sources. We talked about a few of those. And the other one is gut health, which is just critically important. So I'm not going to guess, I'm going to test. And so you're walking out and you're pretty much leaving my office with a 2-week detox, which is awesome. And it's not a starvation program. It's not a deprivation. You eat when you're hungry. You don't when you're not, but you're eating really good anti-inflammatory foods. You're having 2 collagen shakes a day. You're always focusing on protein, fat, and fiber, foods from the earth, more from the farm, less from the factory. Most of the foods you're eating do not have even a nutritional panel, because they're from the earth. So people love that. And after 2 weeks of being on that, then we get your labs back. And most of the symptoms, if not all, usually go away after the detox. If they don't, that's telling as well. Then we keep chasing it. So I have a really good idea of what's going on. At that 2-week mark, I get my information, and then I can see the dartboard, right? I can see where the target is.
Yeah.
Then we do an eating program that is designed for your current health status. And we do supportive supplements if needed for any, you know, inflammation, whatever it is that we need to do, but it's all natural.
Yeah. And once you start working with people and they're trying to change their nutrition, because the clients that I work with, and sometimes we're talking about, you know, their health goals and whether it's weight loss or just overall wanting to feel better. And I think I've been through a detox before, and I know that I didn't realize how bad I was feeling until I got the bad out, right? And then you're like, whoa, okay, I wasn't supposed to be feeling that way. And so that can be a real motivation. But for the mompreneurs who are listening, and, you know, they're juggling entrepreneurship, they're juggling kids, and they're juggling all the roles and hats that they wear, I find for a lot of people, it's the nutrition part that they just get overwhelmed with. There's so much information out there, and one person's telling you to do this, and one person's telling you that. And I know with the work that you do, it's like so tailored, because you have the information in front of you. You can guide them in that direction. But how can we just simplify this down so that people actually implement? Because they just get overwhelmed is what I hear the most. Or they stick with it for a little while and they're like, oh, I don't have time, which we can totally coach around that. I don't have time. It's just an excuse. We know this. There's time. You make time for what matters most, right? But I do understand nutrition is the hardest thing for most people. It's not the exercising. It's not the hydration. It's what they're putting in their body. So what advice would you give to someone who's listening that is that mompreneur that's juggling it and trying to figure that out? Hey, friend, can I give you permission today? Like, for real, your own permission slip. Permission to get clear, to cut out the noise, mostly the noise that is going on around in your own mind, in your own head. It's just swirling. And you're asking yourself questions like, why am I stuck? Why am I frustrated? Why am I not making progress on my goals. I want to invite you to a free clarity call with me where we're going to dive in and we're going to identify what are the three main issues that are keeping you stuck. Number two, what are the mindsets around those issues that are actually keeping you from solving for those issues? It's not our skill sets, it's our mindsets that keep us stuck and hold us back. And then number three, identifying what are your next steps? We all have a next step and we have 100% responsibility for those next steps. Your only next step right now is to go to the show notes and book your free clarity call so that we can work through this. I'm believing in you and I cannot wait to see you on our clarity call.
Well, I'm happy to share that. But the first thing I want to say is that weight loss is a side effect of wellness.
I love that. I actually wrote that down. Like, I want to talk about that because I believe that too. Like, when you're focused on health gains, weight loss happens.
Yeah, we'll get into that next. So I just wanted to mention that, but we'll dive deeper after I answer this question. But basically, you know, I have a saying in my office. I have a few of them, but one of the sayings I have is you get what you get when you do what you do, right? And that goes both ways, right? And so I say to business people, I mean, would you go to a big presentation that your business is on the line? This is, if you get this order, it's going to make a big difference in your business. Mm-hmm. If you go and just wing it, or would you prep? You would make a presentation, you would do some research, you would really do some diligent work on making this presentation the best it could be so that you have a higher odds of getting this contract or this sale or whatever it is that is going to really make a difference in your business. Mm-hmm. Even the little ones, I would imagine you put more effort into, right?
Yeah.
We have to be prepared if we want to have success. And it's just one of those things. The other thing I say is, you know, I've been very fortunate. I've been able to work with very successful people, and I have very successful people in my personal life as well. And I'm friends with elite athletes. I've worked with Freddie Couples, one of our greatest golfers of all time.
Yeah.
You know, all successful people, whether it's a business success or it's an athlete or it's a music artist or it's if it's a successful relationship. Everybody contains the exact same two attributes. They all possess these two attributes. One is sacrifice and the other is consistency, discipline, right?
Right. Yeah.
And we know that owning a business, we have to do our taxes even when we don't feel like it. We have to deal with shipping errors or customer problems, even when we don't feel like it, even if we're on vacation, we just have to get that done. Right. And we have to make continuous sacrifices. Nobody knows that better than a mom. Right.
Right. Yeah.
If you need something in the middle of the night, you're not going to be like, let me know in the morning. You're going to take care of that, right?
Yeah.
You know, I feel like I'm going to throw up. You're going to get and take care of that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we know about sacrifices. So those are two attributes that every successful person I know has. And so if you want to be successful with your health, you have to do it. It's not something that's just given to us. We have work at it. And unfortunately, we have so many options of drive by and order in and take out and freeze and microwave or whatever it is that it makes it easy to check it off the box, but it's not really optimal.
Yeah.
So preparation is key. I'm extremely busy. You know, I have two businesses. I have kids, you know, they're not in my house anymore, but I have a very, very busy life. And I take that time on Sundays or Monday mornings and I make my chicken salad. I chopped up my vegetables. I make my hard boiled eggs so that when I have a break in my business day, I am grabbing or I'm just getting it and bringing it. Last night I made a salad with some halibut on it. Beautiful with my pesto sauce that I make. And then I brought that for lunch today. So, you know, a second serving. So I will not put that at the back burner because if I don't eat well, I don't, first of all, go and grab. So I'm going to be starving, which is not going to be good for my blood sugar. So I have to. It's a main priority for me. So we just have to make that a priority.
Yeah. And it's hard in the beginning, but then I know I find for me that when I do prepare well, you feel better. You're like you said, you're not grabbing for those convenience foods. And you know what's in your plate and what's going into your body, and it fuels you. And if you think about a mom and a mom entrepreneur, we need to be fueling our bodies in the way that's going to help us to show up well for everyone else. So talk about that a lot on the on this podcast. And we talk a lot about burnout too. So I would be interested to know with the people that you've worked with related to this, do you see a lot of your clients coming in maybe in a state of burnout and that's also not helping their situation?
For sure. Adrenal fatigue, cortisol production, excess cortisol production, which is our stress hormone, is a thing. You know, between phones and computers, and we're just working all the time. When do we plug? When do we laugh? When do we walk in the sand or the grass or the, you know, when do we do that? We're just so focused on the next and we'll get this email out and get this order in or get the, you know, we're on this treadmill and it is not good for our health. It's one of my least favorite things to work with because it moves slowly. And when cortisol is high or cortisol is low, you will not lose weight. You will not feel well. And it messes up so many things. It's, you know, one of our departments in our endocrine system, and it really has a severe impact. So we have to take that time for ourselves and to just unplug. We just have
to. Yeah. What do you mean it goes slowly? Can you explain that?
Yeah. So there's certain body parts that will move quicker, like blood sugar dysregulation can move quicker for some people, you know, if they're really, really diligent about it. Now, every body is different. So there's some that it may not, but for the most part, I see that if somebody is really diligent about it, they're taking Berberine, they're exercising, they're sleeping, they're eating well, that blood sugar is going to move. Sex hormones, same kind of thing. If we can address the sex hormones, that will move. That can also take a long time too, depending on what your situation is. And if you're, you know, it's just, it depends a lot. But cortisol, you know, there's five reasons why we gain weight and five reasons why we can't lose weight easily. One is blood sugar dysregulation, which I just talked about. The other is thyroid dysregulation. And the thyroid is also one of those things that can move a little slowly as well. But we need to make sure thyroid is optimal. Now, if you are stressed, if you have a lot of cortisol production, chronic stress, it's going to affect your thyroid. It's going to affect blood sugars. It's going to affect your hormones. So it's like this perfect harmony. The other one is cortisol, as we talked about. That's the you know, imbalance of your stress hormones. And it could not just be from work. It could be family, relationship, food stress, right? If we're eating processed foods, it could be environmental stress, molds or mercury or toxic chemicals, toxic overload. It could be from that as well. And then what did I say? Thyroid, cortisol, sex hormones, blood sugar, and a buildup of toxins. Toxins live in our cells, fat cells and fat tissue. So that's why we lose weight when we do the detox. Everybody loves it for that, but it's not a weight loss program, I tell people, even though you're going to lose weight, it's a weight loss program.
Yeah. Well, let's talk about that because we wanted to circle back to one of your foundational beliefs about wellness and weight loss. So can you spend a little bit of time talking about that?
Yeah. So those five reasons that I just mentioned are a huge contributor to maybe somebody's like eating great, exercising, doing all the right things, and they're not losing weight. Then I'm down that list to look at which five it is, right? I'm going to detox you right off the bat. So we'll take care of that. If you lose weight on the detox, well, everybody does, but if you lose a lot of weight on the detox, it tells me that your thyroid's probably working more optimally, or maybe your cortisol's not that bad. And then I'm looking at other things, right? If you lose very little, then I know something's off. Something is dysregulated on those five and I'll start figuring that out. But basically, you know, the one major underlying reason why we will not lose weight or why we'll gain weight is because, again, we have this fire in the basement. We have a major inflammation issue and we're feeding it, right? Bread, sugar, dairy, and alcohol, toxins, all these things, stress, it's going to increase that fire. And when you have a fire in the basement, it's kind of like somebody saying to you, hey, can you help me change the light bulb on the second floor? And you're like, what? I've got the fire department coming. We got a raging fire in the basement. But when the fire's out, you'd be happy to change the light bulb, right? So people lose weight, but they've got this raging fire. They've got all this inflammation. When we're in an inflamed state, our body is in protection mode, right? We're trying to cope with that assault. So we're going to hold on to all our resources. We start storing our iron. We start holding on to fat because we don't know when we're going to need that, right? We use it for excess, right? If we if all of a sudden the food doesn't come in, we're going to start using it as our carbohydrate source, our fuel source to make energy. So having, you know, looking at your inflammatory markers is huge, just huge loss.
Yeah. Yeah. So time-wise, again, like again, because we know that's probably one of the reasons why people don't get started, it was going to take too long. I'm not going to see the results fast enough. So would you, is there an average time that you see someone coming in and working with you and they're not just the weight loss, but like you said, overall, just those markers are starting to go in the right direction. Like how long should someone expect to go through that process before they're seeing something?
So we usually see it in the first week, right? We're going to see the needle move in the first week. If we don't, then there's really issues. But I would say 95, 98% of the people I work with, the needle moves in the first week. The headaches go, the skin clears up, the pooping is more regular, the energy is better, weight loss, whatever it is, usually we start to see the needle move. When I was working with Freddie Couples, you know, he came in, he wanted to lose 20 pounds before the Masters. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, okay, Freddie, no problem on that. But tell me about the back pain that you have, like chronic back pain that it was famous for, carted off golf courses with. And he's like, oh, I'm at a 7 or an 8 out of 10 of pain every single day. So I, you know, we went through all this whole health history and I said, well, what where are the surgeries? Because I've never had a surgery. I'm like, has anybody ever tested you for inflammation? He says, I don't think. Yeah. So I ordered all these tests. Both of his homes are on golf courses.
Yeah.
He works on golf courses. Golf courses are treated with tons of chemicals.
Chemicals. Yeah. Yeah. That makes so much sense. Yeah. Right.
So he's been breathing this day in and day out. And all his symptoms really matched up to this toxicity. So he came in my office, which most people do, but I'm just picking on him because he had very, very high levels of inflammation. The very first week I said to him, what's your number? And he said, I'm a 4. He went from a 7 or an 8 to a 4. And then every week ever that I had ever worked with him again, he was always a 0 or 1.
Yeah.
And so once you get those toxins out, you start to see he was having headaches and smell sensitivities and things like that. So for him, those all went away. For the Masters, he had a great round, all that stuff happened. But I mean, I could tell you a gazillion examples of this. You know, I worked with a surgeon a while ago. I worked with his whole family and I get a call from the wife one day and she's like, I can't believe it, but my husband wants to come see you. So I'm like, okay, bring it. Let's do it. And so he came to see me and we worked together. We changed his diet. He completely said, I need to change my practice. And I have to talk about food with my patients. Anyway, the very last session that we had, he said, I have to share something with you. I said, sure, what is it? And he said, I went to an audiologist a couple of years ago. He was like 50 at the time. I think maybe 51. Went to an audiologist and his hearing was so bad, they gave him a hearing aid. He never told me about that on our appointments. But he said he had gone to the audiologist in the hospital the right before our appointment, a couple of days before. And the doctor said to him, I don't know what you're doing, but you do not need a hearing aid. Mm-hmm. So I said to him, what do you think it is? Which I had my, my thoughts, but he said exactly what I thought it was as well. He said, it's got to be the systemic inflammation.
Yeah.
And sure enough, it was causing, you know, hearing loss. So I've seen, I could go on and on and on.
Yeah.
Because I've seen so many amazing things happen. If you decrease that systemic inflammation, you increase that good gut health, the body is resilient. It wants to heal. You just take the blocks away from it, stop putting in the blocks in the system and take them out. And the body can usually just bounce right back.
Yeah. 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 Our bodies are amazing when we set it up in the right environment to do what it was created to do. So, and I think that's what I love about just like you kind of said, what's trending right now and just the, like how people are just more getting on board with this. I feel the same way about burnout for so long. I think hustle culture, and it's still there a little bit, but there's definitely way more information or way more, people out there talking about, you know, anti-hustle. I'm all about working hard, but hustling and sacrificing your health and your marriage and all the things in pursuit of success is something that I talk about a lot on the podcast. But I'm just thankful these conversations are happening about, you know, autoimmune disorder and functional medicine and nutrition and menopause. I mean, I feel like it's everywhere right now talking about menopause and women don't have to suffer like generations in the past and, you know, just deal with it kind of thing. So I'm sure in your field, you get excited when you see that these conversations are becoming more normal. It's like normalizing it.
Absolutely. And more information and more acceptance. And I think podcasts actually have a really big role in that. I think we're getting information out so people have more access to information because we don't get it typically when we go to the doctor, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Mm-mm. And the doctor, it's not really their fault, but the insurance company is like, you want to make some money, you got to have 15-minute appointments maximum.
Yeah.
You're like out the door and you're like, what just happened? And you wait months to get in there, right? And then you don't get any information. I remember when I was told that I had Hashimoto's, and right after that, I was like, well, what does this mean? And they're like, oh, your time's up. You'll have to make another appointment. I go, you're sending me out the door without a handout or any information on this. And it was a naturopathic doctor who did that. So that's why we're seeing so many more physicians going to all cash, because they can give their patients the time that's needed, because they're not waiting for insurance companies to hope that they'll reimburse them.
You know,
they have expenses. So our whole paradigm is really broken. And I hope that we are in the process, or the very beginning stages, of really making an impact here and changing things. But I do really believe that people like you are giving people more information that they can accept and feel, like you said, normal, and you know, that they're not the odd man out, or, you know.
And that they have access to, there are people out there who truly do care and will spend the time with you to figure it out. They're not just going to give you a blanket answer, but they're going to help. But you do have to be your biggest advocate too, right? Like, you have to take the initiative, like you said, take, you know, what were the two things you talked about? Consistency and what was the first one you said?
Sacrifice.
Right. And so that starts with you, you know, and I'm really big about personal responsibility. So now you have this information, those of you that are listening, and maybe there's someone that you know that needs the information. So I really would suggest that you share this episode with those who, I'm sure you're having talks with your girlfriends, you know, when you're out to dinner, or maybe you're at the park with the kids and you have this resource now here on the podcast. And so tell them where they can find more about you and what you're most excited about right now in your business.
Yeah. So you can find me on my website at Risa Grux Nutrition, RISAGROUX Nutrition. I am in Newport Beach, California, but I work with people all over the country. I have a thyroid course that I put on my website. It's an online course that I put my heart and soul in. Everything I've learned about thyroid through all these years of working with it, with others and myself, and being able to reverse mine, talks about what to eat, what not to eat, what supplements to take, what not to take, how to read your blood work, which I think is so important. For every situation, hyper, hypo, autoimmune, and thyroidectomy. So it's really for everybody. Then I have my book there, Food Frame. Diet is a four-letter word, because I believe that we should all be eating according to our current health status. That one diet type is not right for every person.
Yeah.
And then I have my detox on there, and tons of products. And I have, you know, everything's gluten-free, dairy-free, soy-free, crap-free. And I have a ton of testimonials, articles, and a million recipes for whatever food frame you are. You can take the food frame quiz on that website as well. Obviously, there's a ton of information on there for people. And then I forgot what your other question was.
Just what you're most excited about.
Oh, yes. There's a couple of things I'm really excited about. I think the major movement right now that is taking place, we just are skimming the very beginnings of it, is customized probiotics. You need a probiotic to poop, we've got that. You need a probiotic for leaky gut, we need a probiotic for protection, for your GLP-1, right? We don't have to take Ozempic and Mounjaro. We can create your own mucosal lining, where you should be creating your own GLP-1. Naturally, we all have that ability. So we're having more customized probiotics, and they are coming. We're just at the precipice of this. And I'm so excited about this, because I feel like, you know, we've known that probiotics are really good for you for a long time.
Yeah.
I also have postbiotics that feed the colon that usually don't, you know, probiotics don't get down to the colon. But the greatest thing is that we're really starting to unpack all the probiotics, what we should do, what we shouldn't do. And I think everybody's been living in the dark for a long time. So I'm super excited about that. And the other thing I'm really excited about, which I do in my office, is genetic testing, because we all have these genes. So I'm hoping by the time my grandchildren are born, which I'm hopeful for, which I hope is happen, because I'm hoping that's really soon. But I'm hoping they'll take their blood and say, okay, here are your genetics. Right?
Yeah.
It doesn't mean you're going to get autoimmunity, but you have a high propensity to have it. So you can make a left. You don't have to go straight. Mm-hmm. You have this, you know, these are your genetics. And now you have choices to either watch out for that, and then our food should be paired with our genetics, our supplements, our nutrients, our vitamins and minerals, they should be also paired for that, because some people can, you know, they need vitamin D more so than other people. And there's, we have genetic testing to test what you have a better ability to digest and absorb, metabolize, where we didn't used to have that information. So I'm super excited about that.
Yeah. Yeah. It's all fascinating to me. It really is. Just so cool to see it all come together, and just more and more people being interested in taking care of their health, right? And taking that responsibility. So I know you have a detox, and you said you had a discount for listeners. Do you want to tell them about that?
Yeah, I'm happy to offer your listeners 10% off my detox for 90 days after this podcast drops. And so we'll put the code in the show notes.
Yeah.
It's awesome detox. I love it. I do it all the time. I just finished one myself. I do it about 3 times a year. And it really, it just reboots you. It's awesome. And yeah, of course, people love it because they lose weight, but it's not about, it's a side effect of wellness. So it's right. A wellness program.
Yeah. And that's such a mindset shift, really is, that it's a side effect of wellness, because we get so focused on the weight loss. But right. If you're focused on the health gains, the weight loss comes. Right.
Right. It's so, like looking at your margins, right? And looking at your profits. So, you know, if your sales are not good, or if your process is not working well, you know, we're focusing on the wrong thing. We should be focusing on the system rather than the result. Right?
Yeah.
System optimally.
Yeah. Well, if you could leave the mompreneurs that listen to this podcast every week with one thing, what would you want them to know today?
Take out the toxins in your life. Watch your cleaning supplies, your makeup, your nail polish, the chemicals that you're putting in your food, the chemicals that you're buying in your food, you know, your candles, your shampoos, everything. Just really take a look at that and try to detox your toxic load. We're just seeing it catch up to us, and it's not good.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Well, thank you so much for coming on. This was great. Lots of great information. I know everyone's going to go in the show notes and find the link to go and do the detox maybe, or just see more about you. So I appreciate you taking the time to come on to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Yes. All right, friends, we will catch you on the next episode. Well, that's a wrap, friends. Thank you for tuning in to today's episode. I really hope it met you right where you are and gave you some encouragement for your day. Could you do me the biggest favor and leave me a rating and review? Seriously, it's the best way for you to support the show. And while you're there, be sure to follow the show so you never miss an episode. Thanks again. And until next time, I am believing in you always.